Morning boys.
So last class
we learnt combination and the permutations, and one examples also I left the final option for selecting the 11 players to play a cricket match. Clear? So the fourth one you have to find out. It is given examples problems only. You find out and work it out and practice. Now we will go to the exercise number 2.5. This principle of mathematical induction. What is mean by principle of mathematical induction is you have to prove some concept with by taking the values 1k and k plus 1th term. That is mathematical inductions. You have to prove some result. The proved result for n is equal to 1 and n is equal to 1000 and so on. We don't know what is the final, we don't know what is the end of the number system. Therefore, you have to prove for n is equal to, in the number system, let's say k. Then what is the next number of k? K plus 1. That is only natural number, isn't it? After k, you'll get only 4k, that is k plus 1. So, if you consider this is true, suppose if I am replacing in this formula, you know this formula, to sum the natural number n into n plus 1 by 2. So, this result we proved already. Clear? So, how do you get this answer? How do you prove this result for all the numbers? That is the technique we called mathematical induction. By using the mathematical induction, we proved this is holds true for all the values of the number, natural number system. So, if you take n is equal to 1, so what is that? 1 plus 2 plus 3. This is only the last number n. We do know what is the last number. That is very important. So, if you replace n by 1, you will get 1 into 1. 2 by 2 is equal to, what is the first number? If you replace n equal to 1, 1 will get only 1. So, you will get, what will be the answer? 1, both sides are equal. And so, if you prove n is equal to, I don't know what is the number, last number, so I consider n is equal to k. So, I got k of k plus 1 by 2 is equal to 1 plus 2 plus up to k. So, if you take this is true, then you have to prove the next stage. K plus 1. If you take k equal to 10, you will get 10 of 11 by 2, that is 55. If you add up to 10, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 5 plus up to 10, you will get same answer. So, what is the next value of k? K plus 1. For this, if you consider this is true, this format is true for the right hand side, then you have to prove this is also the same statement for n is equal to k plus 1 also true by replacing n is equal to k plus 1. Clear? So, this is called mathematical induction. This they can use very well in algebra and quadrilateral geometry. The result, it is equation format. Now, equation means comes only in where? In algebraic, in algebra. So, we will go to straight away the question number 1. That is 1 cube plus 2 cube, 3 cube, etc., etc., plus n cube, n square, n plus 1 square by 4. This is nothing but, you studied already in 10th standard, 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube plus etc., etc. This is standard result. Clear? So, you there will be a questions to find the solution, solved by using the special formula, special functions, 1 cube plus 2 cube plus extra extra plus 20 cube. If it's so, what are doing? You are replacing n by 20 in that formula. This is the general formula. It is already proved. Left side is equal to right side. It is proved. Now you have to prove the right side formula is holds true for all the values of n, positive values. That is only mathematical induction. Clear? Now you have to start from, the rule is first you have to start n is equal to 1, then you have to replace n is that you have to consider this is true. If you replace n is equal to k, you consider this formula is true. Then you have to replace next a k plus 1 in the place of n. You have to prove that. To prove that is k plus 1 is true. After considering n is equal to k is true. If I say that when I say n is equal to 10 is holds true for this formula, then I have to prove what is the answer for n is equal to 11, whether it is satisfied this condition or not. That's all. That is called mathematical induction. So these are the rules. Rule number 1, first you take replace n is equal to 1, and rule number 2, you consider, you assume that it is true for k, and you have to prove that it is also true for proved for k plus 1 to term. Clear? So what is the concept of these two? If I consider when n is equal to 10, it is true for this format. It is true when both sides are equal, when n equal to 1, n equal to 10. Then I consider when n equal to 10, this is holds true. Then I have to prove what is the possibility of next number of 10. What is the next number of 10? 11. So I have to prove it is satisfied when I am replacing n by 11 on both sides. That is the concept. That is mathematical induction. So explanation maybe is confused you a little bit, but when you work out the problems, that will be very easy. So what is mathematical induction? You have to consider the sum of the term in the middle of the statement of the given sequence series is considered as true. You have to prove the rest of the part as true for all the values of n. That is called mathematical inductions. So now you start from the question number 1. First you have to replace n by 1. So you supposed to consider that p of n is equal to 1 cube plus 2 cube plus extra extra plus n cube. You consider this given as one polynomial like p of n. It is comes vastly used in algebra. Clear? Now n is equal to 1. If you replace n is equal to 1, then you will get 1 cube. There also you have to replace 1. 1 plus 1 the whole square by 4. 1, this is also 1. 1 plus 1, 2. 2 square is how much? 4. So we can cancel, you will get 1 is equal to 1. So P of 1 is true. So what is the next condition? Next condition you have to suppose to take n is equal to k, that you have to consider is true. N is equal, assume n is equal to k is true. So what is that? P of k is equal to k square. Just replace n is equal to k, that's all. Don't confuse. Assume n is equal to k is true. Second condition, or what is third condition? You have to prove that. To prove that p of k plus 1 is also true. So what will do? Again you have to replace both side n by k plus 1. Both left side as well as right side. If it is not confused one, it will be very easy. Clear? Only you have to keep it in your mind for mathematical induction. First you have to replace by n is equal to 1. You prove it is satisfied. Both sides are equal. So P of 1 is true. Next you have to consider n of k is true. So once you consider n of k is true, then you have to replace in the place of n by k. You have to write 1 cube plus up to. So I consider P of k is equal to this one. So this indicates, what is this? This indicate 1 cube plus 2 cube extra extra plus k cube. So this is indicates, if I am say p of n means you have to consider 1 cube plus up to n. If it is say p of, If I am saying that P of k, which means you have to consider 1 cube plus 2 cube plus extra extra k cube. Clear? So that's what I consider P of n. Generally, I name it as P of n. If I am replacing P, if I say P of 1 means that you have to take right side, 1 cube. So if I am saying P of k, you have to write the left side up to k cube. We don't know what is the number k. K is one number, I don't know what is it, be 10 or 11, I don't know. So generally, we will take it as 1 all bets. Inversely, they are taking as k. Now, I consider this is for k, it is true. Now, I have to prove that when n equal to k plus 1, what do you mean for k plus 1? Next number of k. If I proved, if I consider up to 10 is, that's both sides are equal, then I instead of prove the 10 is holds true for both the side. If I prove number 11 is satisfying these two sides, then automatically 10 is also comes in that category. It is also holds true. That is the meaning. When the number 11 is satisfied these two relations, then automatically what? 10 is also going to be the absolute. There is no doubt of that number 10 is not satisfying both sides. That is meaningless, senseless one argument. Clear? So if I am saying that number 12 is holds true for this given statement, automatically from number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 11, it will be holds true. That is the main concept. So, if I prove n is equal to k plus 1 is true, k plus 1th term is true, automatically the number starting from 1 to k is also holds true. Now you understand what it means that? If I prove, for example, I started for example up to 13, if I prove the number 13 satisfied one function or whatever one formula, then what is the meaning that 12 up to 12 also holds true. So no need to check for all the numbers. That is called mathematical index. That's what I am using. K plus 1 is true. If you prove k plus 1 is true for this given statement, automatically up to k is also true. That is mathematical indexes. Now, I have to replace in the place of n by k plus 1. 1 cube, 2 cube, 3 cube, extra, extra. N is replaced by k plus 1 power 3. This n. In the right side also, I am supposed to replace n by k plus 1. K plus 1. K plus 1 plus 1, this is square, here also square, by 4. Now I can rewrite the left side. What is the number before k plus 1? This I explained. The two, I think exercise number 2.3. Clear? So what is the number before k plus 1? What is the number before 10? 9. Likewise, what is the number before k plus 1? K. K cube. K plus 1 whole cube. So k plus 1 the whole square. This is 1 plus 1, 2, the whole square by 4. Now I consider already this is true. 1 cube up to k cube I consider as true. Clear? After considering this is true, I have to prove that for k plus 1 also true. So 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube plus k cube can be replaced by k square k plus 1 the whole square by 4 plus k plus 1 the whole cube is equal to k plus 1 the whole square k plus 2 the whole square by 4. Clear? Now you have to simplify. You have to bring the right side is equal to left side. So you can simplify. See the left side. What is the common factor of these two terms in the left hand side? K plus 1 square. Actually, what you have to prove? What is the final answer? You have to prove the right side is equal to left side. You simplify only the left side. Don't disturb the right hand side. Clear? Just you have to keep it. Suppose if you don't have, so if you have any confusion regarding this one, so you, next step itself, you have to write what is there on the right hand side. They will give the marks. But you should know how to simplify it. Sir told already in the class itself. After these steps, you can write what is there on the right side. Hence, you write it is proved for K plus 1. So don't do like that. Clear? So some of you are not able to properly understand this concept. For those, I suggested you after this step, you please straight away write this answer and conclude. That's all. Clear? But you should learn. You are 11th standard. Know how to simplify these two terms. You learned already in the lower classes. So, just you have to find the common factor. What is the common factor of these two? The common factor of these two is k plus 1 the whole square. K square, if I am taking k plus 1 the whole square outside, what are the factors are remainder? K square by 4. Plus, out of 3 factor, I take how many factor outside? 2 factors outside. Therefore, I will get k plus 1. That's all. By 1 you take. You have to write the right hand side as it is. So don't disturb. You have to write the right hand side as it is. Now you can apply the cross multiplications. Clear? So k plus 1. K plus 1 the whole square cross multiply, that is, you are supposed to take LCM, but you should say always cross multiplication you cannot apply. The word cross multiplication cannot be applied in the case of the term. If it is an equation form, if it is equal to format, if it is k square by 4 is equal to k plus 1 by 4, 1, here you can use the word cross multiplications. If there is a plus or minus in between the two terms, then you don't use the word cross multiplication, but normally the math teachers are used to take cross multiplications, but that is not correct. You are supposed to take the word LSA. But normally you are used to apply the cross multiplication to get the answer. Clear? So actually you have to take LCM. So 1 into k square plus 4k plus 4. When you multiply this 4, you are supposed to multiply 4 into k and also 4 into 1. So some of the boys I noticed in the past years, when they go for this LCM or cross multiplication, they are multiplying only the first term. They multiplied like 4k, then they wrote 1 as it is. They did not multiply this constant by 4. That mistakes most of the boys are doing. So avoid, whenever you multiply, you please note very carefully. You have to multiply both the terms, even if it is more than 2 terms or 4 terms. You multiply all the terms by whatever the number that you are willing to multiply. Clear? So you have to multiply. Don't write like this. Don't multiply only the first term alone. You have to multiply both terms. So what is the right side? What will be the right side? Right side is given k plus 1 the whole square, k plus 2 the whole square by 4. It is there on the right hand side. Now, this is 4. You see, what is this? This is exactly refers to a square plus 2ab plus b square. That is a square plus 2ab plus b square. Sir, you are the teacher, so you know this is can be written as in the form of a plus b the whole square. But how do you find out whether it is in the form of a plus b the whole square or not? Very simple. When you go for anywhere, not only for this problem, if you see any two square number, clear, if you see, first you have to check whether you have two square number or not, square terms, k has power 2, therefore this is square term. 4 is a perfect square number of 2, 2 square. Then you have to check 2ab. So you know very clearly, this is not necessary, just for your explanation purpose I did. How do you get this answer from this? Clear. So most of you don't know how to get this answer by using this identity. So if you are not able to use this identity, better you'll go for factorization method. Because all of you know very well factorization. So either you go for a square plus 2ab plus b square method, that is a is k and b square is 4 means b square is 4, which implies b is equal to how much? 2. So you have to check only 2ab because I know what is a square, k square. What is b square? 4. So I have to check 2ab. 2 into k into b is 2, that is 4ab. It is there. That is 4ab, that is 4k. Is there in the middle? Therefore, you can rewrite this in terms of a plus b square, which implies very clearly k plus 2 the whole square. You will get by using this concept. No, sir, I don't know the formula. If the boys doesn't know that a plus b the whole square formula, then how do you simplify this one? Better you'll go to the factorization method. So that is very simple, I think so. What is factorization method? What is the last number? 4. Split 2 to 4. When you add these two, you will get 4. Therefore, you can write k plus 1 the whole square. This is k plus 2 into k plus 2. Factorization you know very well. Clear? 4. Now k plus 2 repeated how many times? 2 times. K plus 1 the whole square, k plus 2 the whole square by 4, which is what? Right hand side. So you have to prove that. Finally you can write P of k plus 1 is true whenever P of k is true. That's all. For n equal to natural numbers, that will be very important. It is natural number because it is always positive, there is no negative. Clear? So it is whole. So this is the process. Very simple. You have to simplify only in the left side when you after replacing n equal to k plus 1 by using P of k formula. Clear? You simplify the left side, normal algebraic simplifications. So I explained how to get this answer from this. Either you go for factorization method or if it is possible to apply identity, that is a plus b the whole square or a minus b the whole square. Are you clear now? So this is very simple. Only thing, remember the condition. First you have to replace n is equal to 1. Then you have to consider n is equal to 2. And you have to prove it is holds true for k plus 1. So when you have to replace in the place of n by k plus 1, then you have to started to apply the P of k formula in the left side alone. Don't write in the right hand side. So what is the number before k plus 1? I already explained in factorial itself. Clear? 2.3. What is the number before n? N minus 1. What is the number before n minus 1? N minus 2, and so on. So same way, what is the number before k plus 1? K. K cube plus. Because, sir, why don't you write up k minus 1 the whole cube? Not necessary. Why it is not necessary? Because I consider up to k is true. If I consider up to k is true means, what is the meaning for k minus 1? That is also true. When the next number is holds true for the previous, next number is holds true for the given result, automatically the previous number of the number is also holds true. That's what I did not use k minus 1 whole cube. Are you clear now? So I consider k is true, then I have to prove k plus 1 is also true. So what is the number before k plus 1? K. What is the power? K cube. For this I know already formula, because I take this is true. I just applied simplification, algebraic simplification, I proved what is the right hand side, k plus 1 the whole square into k plus 2 the whole square by 4, that is the right hand side. You supposed to write clear this result. That's what I am writing straight away, is equal to right hand side. This result you have to write over here, then the statement. Over. Clear. Clear, not clear. If you have any doubt, not only for this problem, any doubt, you please call me over the phone. I will clear your doubts. So, don't hesitate to ask your doubts over the phone. But before 9 o'clock. Not after 9 o'clock. Some of the boys are changing again WhatsApp number. Please don't change. Now the question number 2. 1 into 2. The dot stands for 2. 2 into 3. 3 into 4. Extra, extra. 2 into n plus 1, n plus 2 by 3. It is proved result. What are the problems are given here? That is already proved. What are the problems are given in this course? Exercise number 2.5, that is standard result. But you have to prove it is holds true for all the number, natural number system. So, what is the first rule to prove the mathematical induction? First, you have to consider the given statement as P of n. 1 into 2 plus 2 into 3 plus extra extra n into n plus 1. So, n is equal to 1. That is the concept. P of 1. This is 1. Is equal to, what is it? Right hand side is given. N into n plus 1 by 2, you replace n by 1 in the right side. 1 into 2 into 3 by, correct or wrong? If you replace n in the place of n, then you have to get left side. See, I got, you have to replace this side also n, n 1 plus 1. So, 2 is equal to, so what will be the answer? Right side, 1 into 2 into 3 by 4, 2, 3, sir, 6 by 4, not possible. So, you have to check whether it is correct or wrong. Here 3, but I wrote here 4, so be careful. So, 3, 2, sir, 6, so 2, 2 equal. It is true. P of 1 is true. Here I wrote 4 instead of 3. It is normal human error. So be cautious of writing the numbers. I am replacing left side as well as right side. N is 1, 1 plus 1. The right side 1 into 1 plus 1 into 1 plus 2. I straight away write on the answer. 1 into 1 plus 1, 2. 1 plus 2, 3. So simplify. Even you can simplify here itself. You will get same answer. Clear. So, P of 1 is true. Next, you have to consider or assume P of K is true. If we consider or assume P of K is true, then what is the formula on the left side? 1 into 2, 2 into 3 plus extra extra. What is that? K into K plus 1 in the right side. K plus 1, K plus 2 by 3. I consider this is true. Now I have to show that, to prove that P of K plus 1 is also true. You have to show that P of K plus 1 is also true. as usual you have to replace in the place of n by k plus 1 on both left side as well as right side. So here we'll go 1 into 2 plus 2 into 3 extra extra. What is that? Plus 1. What is there on the right hand side? In the right hand side we have k plus 1. Replace k plus 1. Plus 1. Here k plus 1 plus 2 over 3. Clear? I am replacing in the place of n by k plus 1 both left side as well as right side. So 1 into 2 into 3 plus k plus 1 k plus 2, just you have to simplify in the right side, k plus 1 k plus 2 k plus 3 by 3. As usual, what is the number before k plus 1, k plus 2? This you know very well. K before k plus 1, k plus 2 is k plus 1 plus k plus 1 into k plus 2 is equal to k plus 1, k plus 2, k plus 3 by 3. What is the number of this is one term, k plus 1 into k plus 2. What is the previous of this term? K plus 1. That's what we have in the previous one. Clear? So, what is the number before k plus 1? K. What is the number before k plus 2? K plus 1. Then you have to write as it is. Now, we already considered from 1 into 2 up to k into k plus 1 is true. What is the formula for up to k into k plus 1? We have k of k plus 1 k plus 2 by 3 plus k plus 1 k plus 2 is equal to k plus 1 k plus 2 k plus 3 by 3. Now as usual you have to simplify the left side alone. And if you prove that the left side answer is equal to exactly right hand side answer, then you have to write P of k plus 1 is true whenever P of k is true for all the values of n which is belongs to natural number. So, normal simplification. What is the common factor of these two? K plus 1. See, k plus 1, k plus 2 present both the terms. So, this is called common factor k plus 1, k plus 2. When I take outside, what is the remainder in the first term? K by 3. What is the remainder of the next one? Nothing. That is 1. Don't take 0. Sir, everything, no, nothing is there when you take outside. If you take factor, then there should be always 1. It's a common factor of all the terms. So, right side you have to write as it is. Now, you can simplify by taking that LCM. So, K plus 2. This is k plus 3 by 3. This is nothing but, what is that? RHS. See, same result. So, you have to write now the statement as P of k plus 1 is true whenever P of k is true when n belongs to that n belongs to natural number. Hence a proof. So, very simple. First you have to consider n is equal to 1. Then you have to assume that n of when n equal p of k is true. Then you have to prove that p of k plus n also true. You have to simplify only the left side. Don't disturb the right side for all the problems for mathematical indexes. So, go through that. If there is any doubt, you may have so many doubts in this exercise. So, let you call me, don't hesitate, don't call after 9 in the night time. So, before that you can call at any time, I'll explain to you. Clear. So, clear the doubts. We will see the remaining problems in the next classes. Thank you, boys.